Hello and welcome back to MedWant's M700 Tutorials. In this short video, I'll briefly explain the Data or Attributes panel, as well as the Annotate tab. The Data panel is shown in Image View and can be toggled on and off in the Display tab. Clicking on the right pane button from the top toolbar displays this list of attributes in the right side of the window. The data displayed now is the default list of attributes. In the top left corner of the data window is a blue refresh button. MedMont Studio normally recalculates values when changes are made to an exam, but you may want to press this when opening a test to force the attributes to recalculate and ensure that all the data is up to date. The patient's age is calculated with the birth date that you entered for the patient and the time the test was taken. The overall defect, which is abbreviated to OD in some printouts, is the mean difference between the age normal hill of vision and the patient's hill of vision. As the name suggests, this measures the overall defect in the visual field. If you aren't familiar with this measurement, you may be more comfortable using the Humphrey equivalent mean defect. This is shown in the HFA MD field, and converting between these measurements has been proven to be reliable. The pattern defect, sometimes called PD, is a statistic that measures the clustering and severity of defects based on spatial correlation. It gives a quantitative measure of the extent to which deviations are spatially correlated or clustered together. In a test with an evenly distributed defect, even if the OD is quite large, the pattern defect will be small, indicating few localized areas of loss. As defects cluster together, the pattern defect index will increase. This is especially prominent in fields with both high clustering and large absolute deviations in the areas of field loss. Like the OD, we have direct conversions to the Humphrey equivalent shown in the HFA PSD field. The overall defect and the pattern defect are also assigned scores based on their severity. Severity is ranked as 1, 2, or 3 asterisks. For OD, these scores are age-referenced, whereas for PD, the significance is independent of age. You can find the numerical cutoff points for each category in the user manual. In the data panel, these statistics are also colored in based on severity. Scores with no asterisks are green, 1 asterisk is orange, and 2 or 3 asterisks are red. Below these statistics is the cluster analysis. The cluster analysis divides the inner field of just under 30 degrees into 9 superior and 9 inferior hemi-field zones, excluding the area plus or minus 30 degrees of the blind spot. The software then compares superior hemifields to their corresponding inferior hemifield to produce a number of defect categories. As an example, if there is no discernible difference between superior and inferior zones, the cluster analysis displays no local defects. If a significant number of either superior or inferior zones are depressed relative to their matching area, the cluster analysis displays superior or inferior depression. You can read more about the other categories and how these statistics are calculated in the M700 user manual. Note that the results of the cluster analysis are intended to highlight the difference between small, matching superior and inferior zones, but have little significance when examining a depression or defect that is not hemifield based. The next two pieces of information relate to the hill of vision. As we've discussed in other videos, the hill of vision is designed to be the best estimate of the patient's vision without accounting for localized defects. The hill of vision is expressed with two parameters. The HOV slope is a linear slope in decibels per 10 degrees and shows how vision falls off as you move from the center to the periphery of a field. The second parameter is HOV 3 degree level, which is the mean threshold of the patient at 3 degrees eccentricity. Below the hill of vision data is information related to reliability, fixation losses, false negatives, and false positives are all shown here. Like the overall defect and pattern defect, you can see that they are colored and give a simple score. There are a range of categories. For example, under 5% is colored green and marked excellent, whereas under 15% is still green but marked with good. Below 25% is also green but labeled as fair, and as you get to 80%, you see that it's colored red and marked with very poor. Finally, in my display I have trials and duration. You can see as always that trials is shown as the number of exposures over the number of stimulus locations, and produces an average number of exposures needed per stimulus point. Now that we've gone through the list, you may have noticed that my screen is not the same as yours, or some statistics were not shown. First of all, if the data is not available for a test, it won't be displayed in the side panel. If your test didn't use false negatives, for example, that won't appear in the data panel. However, the more important point to take away from this is that the data panel is fully customizable. Pressing on the Arrange Attributes button in the top of this panel will bring up a window allowing you to select what to show here. The left side of this window shows all the attributes that are available, while the right side shows the ones that are currently selected. You can highlight one or more of these attributes by holding down the Control button and selecting multiple attributes. Pressing the directional arrow will then move these highlighted attributes to the opposite column. Pressing one of the double arrows down here will move all of the attributes from one column to the other. You can move the order of selected attributes by highlighting them and pressing the up or down arrow on the right. As you can see, there are a number of selected attributes that are not displayed in my data panel. CV index, for example, is an attribute that will only display for a CV percent 100 point test. I'm going to press cancel to return to my display window without making any changes, but if you want to save your changes, press apply or OK. The other button available in the top of the data panel is the attributes button. Pressing this gives you data on how attributes are defined, allows you to edit currently existing ones, as well as define and export your own, or import new attributes from another source. The New Attributes button gives you a huge amount of power in building your own data. For example, pressing New Calculated Attribute lets you pull any of the raw data that was collected during a test and calculate your own values from it. You can even create a new code block to interface with the software. However, many people don't use this feature, and an in-depth look at how to build attributes is out of the scope of this tutorial. If you're interested in learning more, please read the Attributes section of the MedMont Studio 6 User Manual. The last point that I'll touch on is the Annotate panel. Though this is primarily used for typography in the DV2000, from here you can mark up an exam with any of the available annotation tools. You can add text or text callouts, draw, and add shapes. Pressing any button activates that tool. For example, if I press the callout button, then click somewhere on the map, a text callout is added. A pop-up with settings for the callout appears first, where I can add and edit text, and you can see a text bubble is now on the map. You can select and move annotations around using the Select button. Double-clicking them, or pressing the right mouse button, and selecting Properties will allow you to edit the annotation properties. Different annotations will have different options, but some of the basic ones are color, line width, and line style. You can also choose when a callout will appear. For example, with a ruler tool, linked is not displayed by default. Double-clicking this annotation and changing callout to show always will display the callout whether the attribute is selected or not. When you're done marking up the exam, you can press the Save button in the top of the data window to save your changes, or the Undo button to remove your markup since your last save. If you forget to save and change exams, MedMont Studio will still ask you if you'd like to save your changes before exiting. Okay, that's the end of this video. Thanks for watching.